Hi friends, this is Shiva Charan. I teach history for the civil service aspirants. And as UPSC already announced its date for the preliminary examination, which is on October 4th. So I thought of uploading some of the important videos related to the modern history, particularly. I hope you will like my videos and you will get something out of it. Thank you very much. So in this video, I am going to discuss the topic ideological differences between Gandhi and Mahatma Gandhi and Subhash Chandra Bose. You see, the first point of conflict arises between Gandhi and Bose in the aspect of socialism. I'll give you the background for this. In 1937 general elections, Congress party achieved absolute majority in 8 provinces out of 11 provinces in the British India. Right? In the very next year, in 1938, Congress session took place in Haripur, for which Bose became the president. When Bose became the president, immediately he passed the orders for all the 8 Congress governments immediately to pass the land reforms. Because you see, the land reforms is a prerequisite to achieve the socialism. It is the Congress party who declared its official goal as a socialism in 1931 Karachi session. Now tell me, how are you going to achieve that socialism? The first and foremost thing you have to do to achieve socialism is to pass the land reforms. Because land reforms suggest for land ceiling. Land ceiling says that maximum of 250 acres shall be contained for the rich landlords or zamindars or aristocrats. And the rest of the wealth which is possessed by these people shall be distributed to the landless laborers. This is the only option to achieve economic equality. This is the only option to achieve social equalities. That's why Bose passed orders for the 8 Congress governments to pass the land reforms. But the problem with this move of Bose is the majority section of the leaders within the Congress party are the landlords. They did not accept this move of Bose. Hence, they all went and requested the Gandhi to oppose the move of Bose. This is where the first point of conflict. Because you see, the Gandhian concept of socialism does not go for imposing the change. Gandhian concept of socialism is called as voluntary socialism. For Gandhi, every individual has a moral responsibility. Every landlord, whether he might be a zamindar or a landlord or aristocrat, he himself shall distribute his surplus wealth to the poor people. This is the idea of Gandhi. Voluntarily, he himself shall distribute his wealth towards the poor people because he is responsible for the society. This is Gandhian socialism, which is nothing but voluntary socialism. Whereas Bose's concept of socialism goes with Marxian socialism. What does Marx say? Marx says class struggle is inevitable. Marx says violence is inevitable to achieve socialism. And for Gandhi, why violence? Let every individual, he himself, distribute his wealth to the poor people. This is the first point of conflict between these two. For Bose, change must be brought from legislation and it has to be enforced by law. Particularly when it comes to the property and assets, nobody will be ready to give or distribute. And what is practical for Gandhi, impractical for Bose? Show me, Gandhi, how many people, how many rich zamindars or landlords distribute their wealth to the poor people. And I say, you can't find fault with both the people. You can't find fault with Bose and also with Gandhi. Very valid observation of Gandhi also. Gandhian concept of socialism, voluntary socialism, is a very valid observation. Because Marxian socialism opts for violence. This is the first point of conflict. Now, in spite of these differences, Bose went for the second time contesting the election in 1939 Tripuri session. And this time Gandhi don't want the Bose to become the president of the Congress party. That's why Gandhi appointed his nominee, his loyalist, Pattabhi Sitaramaya, for contesting the election. And in spite of Gandhi's campaigning, in spite of Gandhi's vocal support for the Pattabhi Sitaramaya, Bose became the president for the second time. Now when Bose became president for the second time in 1939, the situation in Europe, Second World War began. When Second World War began, Bose had the clear picture of what is going to happen in the Second World War. There is no chance for the England to survive in the Second World War. There is no chance for England to survive. Hitler ransacked the Poland within just 6 hours. Superpower in the European politics, France surrendered to Germany within 3 weeks. Hitler, time and again, he declared that he is going to bring down the England to dust. And there is no chance for England to survive. In this circumstance, and if this is the situation in Europe, now look at the situation in Asia. Japan entered into the Second World War supporting the Germany and Italy. Japan entered into the Second World War by giving the slogan Asia for Asians. And when America gave the slogan America for Americans, then why not Asia say Asia for Asians? Who is British in Asia? Let us make the British quit this Asia. Right? And both wanted to take the help of this Axis powers, Germany, Japan and Italy, and get independence from the British. Because this is a immense, this is a very good opportunity for India to get independence. Under these circumstances, Bose requested the Gandhi to start the People's Movement. Because already externally there is a lot of pressure on the British from Germany, Japan and Italy. And let us internally also put a whole lot of pressure. That's why he requested the Gandhi to start the People's Movement. And Gandhi rejected. Gandhi turned down the request of the Bose of starting the People's Movement on moral and ethical grounds. What is moral and ethical grounds? Understand, my friends. Starting the People's Movement in India during the time of Second World War, it means weakening the British. Of course, weakening the British means strengthening the Germany, Hitler's Nazism and Mussolini's fascism, which is immoral. Because Hitler is a curse to the modern world. Hitler killed 5 lakh Jews in Germany. Mussolini also have done the same thing. And how can I support them? Therefore, violence. It's against the principles of Gandhi. And also, we should not weaken the British. This man is very sympathetic to the British in India. Okay, he have the confidence of the British, but for Bose, this is the best opportunity to get independence. These are the main point of conflicts between Gandhi and Bose. Okay, and in my next video, I'll come up with more and more important topics in the examination point of view. I hope you like it, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.